Hello and welcome to this third tutorial on the interactive costing tool. Today we're going to be looking at validation and the processes that occur after the feasibility team have forwarded on to the industry single point of contact email address. Before we start, we'll need to make some assumptions for things that would have already occurred at this point. First is that before you watch this video, I would urge you to watch the second video relating to the actions of the feasibility team, as it links directly to the beginning of this process. Secondly, you will need to have registered your user account within CPMS using the industry single point of contact email address as the main link. And third, that you've read and understood the validation SOP from March 2019 in relation to the interactive costing tool. Just to reiterate, this is not a tutorial into the use of the SOP, it is a tutorial into the use of the interactive costing tool itself to perform the SOP. So, without further ado, after you've received an email from the feasibility team telling you you have a study within the iCT to validate, you will log into CPMS and go to the CRN submissions page, where you will see a study and a study resource review status in progress. This means it has been assigned to you as the validator. First thing you do is you click on the study itself, and we find ourselves in this page. The three areas of this page that you will need to concentrate on will be the responses and attachments, the interactive costing tool itself, and the status tab. So the first thing you will need to do is to look at the protocol that will have been attached, and you'll find it here. So let's have a quick look at that. We're going to take this Excel spreadsheet as being a basic protocol schedule of events. As you can see, there are the activities, the visits, and the individual procedures with the occurrences. I've already highlighted this, and that's to show the differences between this protocol schedule of events and what is currently sitting within CPMS. So let's have a look at that now. Going back to the submission details, and we can click on the interactive costing tool, and it shows us that we have one arm on the study that we need to validate. And this is the arm. As you will see, if I scroll down, there are no items listed under unscheduled activities. There is only one item listed under some participant scheduled activities, and the majority of the protocol is registered here. It's also worth noting at this point that there are already two comment tabs where industry has already commented on changes that it has made before the study has got to validation. So let's quickly go back to the schedule of events that I showed in Excel. In short, if one compares this with the study that we have within CPMS, we will note that the blood sample that's taken here also states that that blood count includes glucose testing. It also states there is a mid-study review, including a telephone visit and a CRF completion, which won't be within CPMS. And it states that additional follow-ups may be required at the request of the patient. You also find that within CPMS, that follow-up visit sits on its own. And finally, there's also a line that's been added to the bottom that says CRF completion at each visit. So if we quickly have a look back at the CPMS entry, we'll see that the blood test says it's blood count and it does not mention glucose. We'll see that the scheduled telephone visit between visits 4 and 5 does not exist. We'll see that there may be the requirement to extend telephone follow-ups beyond the end of the study does not exist within the additional unscheduled activity, and that within the occurrences for all patients, there is no line for CRF completion. So what we need to do is we need to ensure the validation is complete by adding those activities. So the first one will be the glucose test. So if we add the activity, we click on investigation, glucose tolerance test, as requested, an additional £6. Comment is mandatory when making the change, so we can state confirm that should be added. And we know this needs to be added at the same time as the blood count. So what we can do is we can reorder the activity to ensure that that occurs right next to the blood count. And we can add each of those activities simply control V-ing, copying and pasting our comment from adding the line to that activity. The second thing we're going to look at is the scheduled telephone follow-up that exists between visit 4 and 5. Again, we need to add a visit and create a visit label. Notice this appears at the right-hand end. Again, we can reorder the order of the individual visits and place it as it is within the protocol between visits 4 and visits 5. And as it's a telephone visit within the individual schedule events, we add it exactly the same way. The third thing is the telephone visits that followed on after the individual scheduled activity. Clicking on the telephone call, we can see that it states 5 minutes. So we add the additional telephone activity down here because we don't know how long it will occur for. As you can see, there is no telephone activity under the procedures list. This means it needs to be entered manually. And hence, it has been added at this point. The final item that was missing from the individual protocol is the completion of CRF. So we add that activity in. Again, we add each individual occurrence where it was missed within the protocol. It's obviously somewhat of an extreme example because it's something that occurs every single visit, but it does highlight requirement to enter a comment within each changed cell. This is the same case for industry as it is for us. It ensures that the correct information is given as to why cells themselves are changed. Also, shouldn't forget that should this additional telephone follow-up occur, then also CRF completion will be required. So that gets added as well. This now means that the costing template that you have in front of you, or the costing tool that you have in front of you, corresponds directly to the schedule of events that's within the costing, within the protocol. Knowing this is the case, we can return to the status menu in this case. You'll notice the study offering status at the bottom. We tick the box and we mark as complete. This means the study resource review has now been completed on a given date with an end date. Please note at this point that ICT and CPMS is not an email system and is not built for communication. It's merely built for maintaining the comments that are added to ICT. There is still a requirement for you to write back via email to the industry partner in order to point out to them that the study resource review stroke validation has been completed on their study. If we go back to the CRN submissions page, we'll see that we now have no submissions left to validate. Thank you for listening, and that's the end of today's tutorial.